Who said that photo manipulation can only be done in Photoshop? Well, today, find out how to turn yourself into a paint stroke vector poster design within Adobe Illustrator. But first, a quick word from today's sponsor, Framer. It's really great being able to show how a design looks, but it's even more impressive if they can actually experience the design itself, as well as understand how it feels and how it behaves. Learn more about Framer later in today's video. There are some key aspects to today's tutorial that you need to get right to ensure the final design is effective. But firstly, you will need two things. Of course, you firstly need an image, and if you don't have a high quality, high resolution image of yourself, then you can use free websites such as unsplash.com as seen here. They have high quality and high resolution imagery for you to grab completely for free. Also, you will need to have some paintbrush vectors, and for that, I'm going to use FreePick. And within FreePick, you need to make sure that you check the vector box and also the free box so that you can then grab your downloads right away. And just give a search for paintbrush vectors. So working on a portrait artboard in Illustrator, I'm arranging multiple brush vectors so they make up one large paint stroke effect. Now you can take your time doing this because you do want to make sure the brush strokes look realistic and they look pretty cool. I like to try and get some of the texture on the edges because I think that adds to the final effect personally. Now it's a good idea to lay the brush strokes over your artboard so you can then gauge how much of your poster will be taken up by the design itself. And you probably will want to cover as much of it as possible. So when you're finally ready, we're going to unite all of the paint strokes together by first clicking and dragging over them and then using the unite function in the Pathfinder window. If you don't know where the Pathfinder window is, you can find it under Window and Pathfinder at the very top. Now most people from this point onwards think it's just a case of using a mask, but that often is not going to work. If I bring over my image and ensure the brush strokes are above the image, and then I select both items, right click and attempt to use a clipping mask, you will see what happens. So to rectify this, what we need to do is first select our brush strokes and then create a compound shape. And this will then allow us to make that clipping mask that we need to use. However, I still have some important things to show you in today's video. So if you want to move the image around independently of the strokes, you will need to come into the toolbar and then hold down a click on the direct selection tool. And this is so you can locate the group selection tool. With this, just click here like so, and then you can shift the image around with the arrows on your keyboard. Also by pressing V on your keyboard, V for a vector, you can use the selection tool and manipulate the image behind the brush strokes. When you're doing this, you should be aware of the edges on your image in relation to the actual brush strokes of your poster. If you move around the image and the edges do not meet the boundaries of your vector, things will look choppy and cut off, and thus the end result isn't going to look decent. So I finished off with three different typographic solutions, and I did that by implementing hierarchy and also font pairing, but let me know which one you think works the best out of the three. So interactive prototyping is the best way to communicate your app or your website's idea. The sponsor of today's video, Framer, is a no-code, free-to-use tool, making it easy for anyone to become a prototyper. You can insert pre-built interactive components in seconds, sliders that actually slide, and inputs that can be filled, as well as buttons that can actually be clicked. Or of course, you can create your own, complete with every state and variation you need. And that's all completely code-free, thanks to the new Smart Components release. Sign up to Framer today at framer.com/Satori. And that link is going to be down in the description box below. I hope you enjoyed following along and making this poster design today. And if you want to see more content, just click a video on screen. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.